Hi, if you're a wildlife photographer, you have a tendency to shoot a lot of images of something, like let's say in my case, look at my Lightroom catalog here, a lot of toucan images, which is a very beautiful bird called the keel-billed toucan, which we photograph on our Costa Rica photo tour when we take people every year to this place. By the way, can I please request you to subscribe to this channel so that you get all the updates that we send? Also, it's a good idea to hit the bell icon so that you get instant notifications when we have new content. So when this bird is actually sitting on a perch and it's actually moving around looking here and there, you have a tendency to shoot a lot of images in this sequence. Chances are sometimes there's not much of a difference between a few images when you compare it with each other. Now, when you go to your library module and you look at your screen like this, it is a lot of cluttered toucan images in your screen. Let's say you just want to see one unique image of this sequence. How do we do that? We take advantage of Lightroom's stacking feature. So when you go ahead and select the first image in this sequence, number 19, which you can see on my thumbnail here, and the last image in this sequence is, let's say there's a video here in 30, number 29 is my last image, and there are about 10 images, or rather 11, 19 to 29 is 11 images, that's what this corner tells me. I have selected 11 images, which is of the same sequence. The difference between these 11 images would be the toucan is turning its head here and there, but there's not much of a difference in exposure or in composition or in anything else except the posture of the toucan. So I wouldn't want to clutter my catalog by showing all of these 11, which takes a couple of rows in my screen here. I'm actually using a 4K monitor here and I'm having a very big resolution. In spite of that, I'm actually seeing 11 images in two rows. Now, if you go ahead and select these 11 images and right click on any one of them and go down to the stacking feature of Lightroom and you say group into stack, what it simply does is it takes all these 11 images and groups them into a pile of images, but you can only see one thumbnail at a time. Now if you notice, all those 11 images became just one thumbnail for you in your library module. And interestingly, it adds an icon on the top here, which is actually a number which tells you how many images are grouped together into a stack. And this is a very cool feature in Lightroom to help you reduce the clutter in your library view. By the way, there's also a very interesting feature called automatically stack images based on the shooting time. That's perhaps very useful for photographers who would like Lightroom to automatically put images together in a stack as well. Lightroom is pretty smart in understanding the timestamp of your photographs and it allows itself to compress all of these into a stack of, let's say, 10, 11 images depending on the time you shot these. Well, a lot of such videos are what you can see in our Toehold TV channel. Don't forget to subscribe by clicking on the bell icon. But if you want to learn Lightroom in depth and want to understand all the features of the software and get a little better at organizing your images and post-processing them, please buy the course called Lightroom Classic CC, for which you can find a link in this description. And I promise you, you'll be a much more organized and a future-proofed photographer. Go ahead and check out that link.